Welcome, you guys. Thanks so much for taking the time to spend your early part of the day here with us. I mean, it's got to be early for you guys, right?
Is it? I can't tell anymore.
Well, welcome back. It's been a while since we've had music from you guys. Let's go back to the early days, because I know that three of you, minus Laurent, you were in a band together in the early days playing in the suburbs of Paris. What kind of stuff were you guys playing? Because you have a very distinctive sound now. I'm kind of curious what you were playing back in the garage.
Was it right from the start, we didn't want to play covers, so we came up with our own songs, which were pretty bad. In the beginning, when you start, it's awful, but the intention was good, I think, to get our 10,000 hours of songwriting pretty quickly.
Right. No, that's great. So, because I would have thought that, because most bands, when they start in the garage, they play cover songs. But that's pretty ambitious to go, screw that, we're just going to do our
own thing. Yeah, that was the idea. But in the beginning, it's a little rough because you're, you know, on top of trying to figure out how to play songs, you have to figure out how to write them. So I think for about a year, I was just fighting, and then we got it out of our system. And
did it sound anything
like fight since then?
Did it sound like anything like Phoenix does today?
I'm sure there was things in I'm sure there were a few things, maybe 8% of Phoenix.
Yeah. Now Laurent, before you finally became a part of everything, you were hanging out with the guys that would later become Daft Punk doing a project.
That's true.
You were almost a robot.
Almost. I'm a cyborg.
Yeah. So what kind of music were you guys doing? Were you doing anything that sounded like Daft Punk? Or
we were doing some weird punk rockish Beach Boys French weird stuff, yeah. People didn't like it.
No?
No.
Did
no,
this
no,
look
no.
more promising when you decided to make the jump?
Sorry?
Did this look more promising?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that's awesome. I think the first time I heard of Phoenix was on the Lost in Translation soundtrack, which is one of my all-time favorite films. Is that where you met your wife, Thomas? Working on
no,
that film?
No, before that, for Virgin Suicides. Oh. I did the song with Air, Playground Love. We were rehearsing with Air in Paris in the same studio, and they were looking for a singer for that song, and they wanted David Bowie. And so it was just a test. You know, it was just there to do a temp. And so I wrote a bit of the lyrics, and I did the temp version, and they were happy with it.
Wow.
So they kept it.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I don't know if they called David Bowie. He said no, maybe. I don't know what.
I don't think they did. I think it was just, this is so great. We got to keep this. It's awesome. I love that song. I mean, because you guys came up alongside Air as well as Daft Punk. I mean, was it a very communal thing in the Paris area?
Yeah, Paris is very small in terms of music-wise. Everybody knows each other. We're maybe one generation younger than the Air and Daft Punk, so we never really hang out with these guys. But then once we had a record deal and once we would play shows, you know, that sense, we would always run into these guys.
Right. 4 years since Bankrupt came out. Why so long? And what have you been doing?
We were, the day we finished the tour, we went to the studio, so we had no real time off. It just takes time.
Right.
When you're bad.